Welcome back, everybody. Game two coming up. Clovis North versus Bullard. I'm VP. That's Goody. And what's interesting about this, you can dance all you like, so don't slow down just because of this. This is a great concept, Goody. This is the Clovis North basketball tournament championship game. When this whole event, the Heart of California Basketball Tournament, came about, they said, hey, why don't we just have our tournament championship game, move it to the Save Mart Center. Pretty cool.
Yeah, that was a great idea. I like how they maximize on the opportunity. Now you get some incentive, and then they get another opportunity to play on this big court. So that was a great idea.
So the Clovis North Bullard game, two very local teams. Clovis just up the road, Bullard right here in Fresno. So you got a very much a local feel for this one. Very interesting because you can go play in an NBA stadium, but if you know each other from right down the street, it's like, hey, I don't care where we play. I've been playing against you since I was in fourth grade, right?
This is a big moment for the city of Fresno. Good opportunity, again, when you get to play at the big stadium, whether that's, you know, in Sacramento, we got the Golden One Center here, you got here, but getting an opportunity to play on this court, they come to these games, they visit these games. It's always a surreal moment as an athlete.
The first game, Bakersfield Christian High School and St. Joe's, we just had. And this is game two of our four-game stretch here on NorCalSportsTV.com. Pleasure to have everybody with us. Bullard and Clovis North.
Introducing the starting lineups for the Clovis North.
Third game will be Monterey Trail and...
At guard, number 10,
Granada.
Lucas Jones. Also at guard, number 11, Christian Calvillo. 6'3", senior guard, number 12, Jalen Bryant.
And now I was looking at the coaching. Are these, is this a brother tandem we got tonight?
Junior guard, 6'3", Jordan Espinoza.
So an even bigger moment. Two brothers getting to coach against each other against their hometown teams.
The Johnson brothers? Or who
are coached by Tony Atkinson.
Oh, the Fields?
Atkinson brothers.
Here we go.
Starting to fill up a little bit more in here. More fans packing it in. Come join us if you're in this Fresno area. I would assume it's going to get filled up even more as the games matriculate. But here we go.
Oh, nice give and go right there.
Both teams knowing each other really well. Championship game. So this is going to be, I think it's going to be closer than we saw in that last matchup for sure. We see a little matchup here by Clovis North. And we see extended pressure by both teams. So full court press, they're keeping their regular intentions no matter where they play at, and I like that.
Go with the ball. Clovis North Broncos in the all-white. The Bullard Knights in the blue. Oh, nice fake. Nice job. The battle in low. That's how you pad your rebound stats. You get 4 and 5. And then the putback.
Basket by Espinosa.
Great effort. But then how about that?
Wiggins with the response. Ooh, try to go behind the back there. Clovis North.
Some good hustle.
Getting the second one in. It seems like they haven't been able to finish on the first, but their effort right now, giving them opportunity to get back on the boards and finish.
Oh, nice give and go right there. Jaleel Jackson with the bucket.
And the Broncos coming back full head of steam.
Wide open look. Oh, that had a nice arc to it. Didn't go. Look at all the offensive rebounds. Probably 10 offensive rebounds already.
There's another one.
And another by the Broncos.
Jalen Bryant for two.
Broncos all over the offensive boards, and you see there's another one, big, strong grab and finish around the rim. Bullard's got to do a better job of finding a white jersey as they are bright as white out here and box out.
Again, Broncos from Clovis North in the white jerseys.
Thank you.
Knights in blue from Bullard. Nice transition D, but still pretty much an easy bucket.
Bryant really getting going, finding his way down low. It's his second bucket on the night.
Shot comes up short. The spin move doesn't go. Rebound Bullard. Coleman with the long pass, stolen.
Defined.
And it's going to be an offensive foul.
Good call by the official on the low end.
Lucas Jones, the freight train, coming right down the middle of the floor. Oh, that's a nice job right there by.
And he went for the fake, but the player didn't go for the fake, so kind of got himself in a conundrum right there and ended up getting an offensive foul.
Maybe my favorite name so far tonight of any player, the young man that took the charge, Javance Coleman. Can you imagine a more beautiful sounding name than Vance?
He got it locked in. His parents was thinking NIL.
Say, man, there's a guy named Vance Palm that's going to call one of your games when you're 18. Across the top. Oh, a nice backdoor cut, but pretty good defense out there. Somehow got it up. Didn't go. How about this big fella? Malik Muslay, 6'8", but, man, he sure looks taller than 6'8", doesn't he? Shot by Gish with a long three.
That was a deep one.
Just underway, the Broncos and the Knights. This is the Clovis North Championship game. They move the location to this venue. Boy, that must have been a great thing to tell your players. Hey, you know that championship game we have? We're playing where the Bulldogs play. Ooh, ton of contact. Look out, ton of contact. He had the big guy fall down on him. Kyshawn Johnson landed right on him.
And they're playing full steam ahead. I like both teams, their tempo, as we see Giff hitting that deep three right there.
Number three, Amundson at the line, shooting two.
McKay Amundson at the line.
And it's a lot of family ties in this game tonight. Great to see. Really good for Fresno high school basketball. And again, we see that full court press. More so a delayed press, right? We want to work that shot clock a little bit. And then at the half court point, they go get it. And you see a trap right there in the corner.
I'm going through all my rosters because coming up next is Monterey Trail and Granada, and then the nightcap, Sierra Canyon at San Joaquin Memorial. The host team in our final tip tonight will be San Joaquin Memorial.
Nice inbounds play, but a legal screen down low. Turnover.
Look at this young man right here. Look at this young man right here by the name of Jarvis Turner, South High School, Bakersfield All-Star, USC Trojan legend, and the co-producer of this great evening. You owe me. Oh, the easy dish to Malik. You think he's 6'8"?
I am biased. We talk about height. I think basketball players, they always put a couple inches on there, but I think he might be taller than 6'8".
Exactly. He may be trying to sneak around.
And Clovis North creating another turnover right there for Bullard.
There's a long ball that goes up, and it's good, made by Edmondson. Yeah, this play's starting to fill up. Oh, what a block by Malik Mousley.
I like it from Mousley, giving us a little Wilson burger, something here on NorCal Sports TV. When you get a block, we call it a Wilson burger.
Yeah, I'm working with the best, folks. I'm working with the best. When I found out I was going to work with you, I started researching you.
Hopefully all good things.
Massive social footprint. Love it. Ultra talented. I'm going to force you to brag about yourself at one of these breaks that we have.
Just a little bit. I'm extremely humble. I looked up VP and I said, man, I got to put my Sunday's best on tonight.
Well, that's true. No question about it. But the fact is, what a great player, great coach, helping our youth. That's the most important thing to me. How about that nice give? The no-look one bouncer, and we have our first timeout. It's going to be a quick 30-second timeout. We'll take a short break here on NorCalSportsTV.com.
Ten seconds to play. They need another three to tie the game. Cubitt, half court. Oh! Cubitt knocks down the half court, ties the game. Oh, my goodness.
Back live action here, and again, I like Clovis North coming out full court press, have not taken the pressure off at all in this 1-2-2. Again, delay press once we get full court at half court. They're trying to go trap every single thing. Bullard unable to finish on that one, just a little short, but I like it in return. Bullard coming out in a press of their own.
Clovis North all over Bullard so far.
And so funny, the brothers have a reverse press, so Bullard runs a 2-2-1 press, and Clovis North runs a 1-2-2 press. I like it.
Well, it's got to be an interesting dynamic, don't you think?
Oh, most definitely. I would assume Thanksgiving was very eventful at their house.
Imagine the competition over the food. Dangerous pass.
But the length they have on that backside, really impressive. Just a little bump on the ground right there. Easy call for the official, but I like the turn of the corner, and you see here backdoor cut unsuccessful, just goes hard to the basket, gets a little bump on the end. Now we're taking the ball out on the baseline side.
Rios will come in for Bullard. The buzzer blows during the action, maybe just inadvertent. Oh, a bump on the steal. Jaleel Jackson makes a great steal, comes up and floats it in, doesn't go, and it'll be a blocking foul underneath the hoop.
We see here that pressure, just nice little float up top, unable to get it, but again, taking the sacrifice. Clovis North always being known for one of those tough type of teams. They're going to take charges. They're going to dive on the ground. They're going to do some of those intangible things. That was a good play right there, just too deep.
19-6, Clovis North High School up over Bullard High School. Again, we said it once, we'll say it again, in case people are just getting to us on NorCalSportsTV.com. This is actually the championship game of the Clovis North basketball tournament. Guys are in practice one day, and Coach Amundson probably come in and said, you know what, guys, we're not going to be playing at home tonight or tomorrow night. We're going over to the Save Mart. Got to be very, very cool moment.
Short on both of those, but most definitely, I know that conversation, maybe they waited. I know a lot of coaches tend to try to not overexcite their players, so they probably told them last minute, and that's always rewarding as well.
Sticky defense getting put on by the Knights. Awesome, great D. Ball comes in the corner. The southpaw pulls the trigger, and that is Gish. The big rebound by the big fella, Malik Muslik, puts it right back up and in. A steal up off the glass, and here comes Clovis North.
It's that pressure. It is tenacious, and you see reach there, shouldn't have. Now you got to catch up, playing catch up with there. That pressure is really causing problems for Bullard.
Couple of substitutions coming back in.
And Bashaw right there, just being in the right place at the right time, getting that basketball and going finishing hard.
A turnover again. Here comes Birchall. Birchall backs it up. There's an open look. And some good coaching right there. They told him to pull it back. Amundson.
How much deja vu is this? Your nephew playing against you right now. You just were having Thanksgiving dinner with him, and now he's going between the legs on you on this court.
Loses control, though. Here comes Coleman. It's up and it's almost good. That'll do it. The first quarter, 23-6. It's all Broncos right now on NorCalSportsTV.com.
All the way up from Los Angeles, heard that. What made you put Miles Little into the camp?
Well, you know, we were looking for an overnight camp that would really help develop his sort of independence. And this looked like a beautiful setting for the kids and also really foster his independence, meet new people. And I want to say one of the best things about this camp, this particular camp, is the ability to see the games live streamed on YouTube. It allows you to not be at camp, but also still participate in that particular part of camp. And so I thought that was really amazing. The announcers were great. The angles, the instant replay, it really made the kids feel special.
Would you bring Miles Little back up to camp?
For sure, 100%. And we're bringing friends. I think one of the wonderful things that I saw when I came to pick him up is how collegial, supportive the older boys are with the younger boys. And I think that is really heartening for me, because that's how I want my boy to be when he grows up. And so I think that he has some really great examples of really kind people on and off the court here.
Well, next year,
you win, play some Texas volleyball.
We're back. Look. Goody and I mean, we've known each other so long that even during the breaks, we just can't help, from shooting the breeze. Right now, the Broncos from Clovis North stamping their name on the first quarter, 23-6. We know there's some bloodline basketball taking place between uncle and nephew, but I don't think that storyline is really going to carry too well when they're down 17. It's all about, we need to get this thing rolling here.
I wonder who is the bigger brother here. Is it Tim or is it Tony? Because right now, if you're Bullard, you're trying to figure out what you can do. But it's, again, handling that pressure. Here's, again, another tip deflection. Clovis North doing what they do best. Their defensive pressure and Price is one of the best in Northern California. So you see they're showing it, and it's on full display right now.
You can walk in front of the camera if you have all access tagged, right? If you have an all access pad, you can walk right in front of us. He looked important. The second of our four games. Nice give and go. The big guy's ready and waiting.
Good find down low. We've had some pretty talented big men in these first two games.
Common denominator, soft hands. They get it across somehow. Oh, that's just how you draw it up, right, Goody?
Loop-de-doo, it fell right on time.
A crazy pass from the far hash, diagonally across the floor, and let it just drop in.
And you see right here, just the perfect timing, right place, right time. Coach, I'm going to go finish it.
Well, you know what's great about that is that David Rios didn't wait, didn't take another dribble, just scooped it up.
No, that was by design.
All right. Oh, carelessness again by the Broncos. Soft floater. They're starting to work their way back into this thing. That's Mark Williams with a nice bucket.
Bullard trying to find some continuity here, get some stops, get some buckets.
Again, trouble, gets out of it, kicks it in the corner. They move the ball around well. Drives into the corner. There's a good look right there.
Bullard giving too many second chance points, and there it is again. Broncos capitalizing off an offensive rebound.
Pressure again from the Broncos. 17-point lead for Clovis North here. Just under six to go here in this first half. This is the Clovis North Tournament Championship being played in the Save Mart Center. Battle for it down low. Foul on the play.
Good hustle right there. I know any coach not upset when you got a hustle foul.
Well, they're so much more aggressive right now.
Bullard just needing to do a better job of taking care of the basketball, being strong with the basketball. Typically when you get a full court pressure or some type of trapping defense, you know that the intensity is going to be high, so you got to be aggressive with the basketball, take care of the basketball. Nice patience, unable to finish down low.
It looks like a zone. It looks like a soft 2-3. Being played by Clovis North, but they seem to match up instantly with any kind of a corner-to-corner pass.
We're definitely trying to trap corners, and you see there a nice finish under the rim, but everything defensively, it's kind of a soft man. Once we get into the corners and trapping corners specifically, right, that's when you see full-out pressure or either a double team, and you got to make the rotations quickly, move the ball quickly.
Missed free throw. That's nice. Really nice. Great pass from Jordan Espinoza. Bryant, go ahead.
Bryant really stepping on big, playing really well for Clovis North.
Here comes a fast break. It is Bryant again. Oh, a nice quick pass. There's the trigger that gets pulled from deep. Oh, and it rolls in and out, rolls around, and comes right back out. A lot of spin on that ball. There's a turnover. And Coach Amundson just a little frustrated right now with the fact that they're down 19 and they're throwing the ball away.
got to take care of the basketball to get some type of dividends out of this game, some type of niche in this crack, almost 19-point lead as you see him hitting the two right there.
Mark Williams gets one. Much needed. Baseline to Bryant. He kicks it back out. Does this one go? It doesn't. So right now, Lucas Jones having a hard time finding the rhythm.
Good, strong move. I like that jump stop and just finding the time to rise up over the defender.
We continue to hear rumors. That the King may show up tonight. It's all speculation.
Possibility. But I like to keep the suspense.
Short shot attempt put up. Another missed bucket by Bullard. They catch him before he even gets to the hole. And I'm talking about Nazar Shadhari.
You see here, Clovis North just trying to get some dribble penetration. If they drive kick really hard, coming down the lane, so they can either get a lane pull up, as you see there, by Admonson, and knocks it down.
Well, you called it. You called it, and it happened. Still putting the pressure on. I thought he was going to go up with it. I thought for sure that Jaleel Jackson, they say no backcourt. I was going to say, the call's got to happen sooner or later, and it is. So right now, 31-12, and Clovis North all over Bullard.
And it's just little things. Their defense is creating so many turnovers. Their execution, find them down low, finish over the top.
Inside to Mustafa, Malik Mustafa for two.
Into the corner. Nice look, and it goes.
Major Hurley.
But Hurley's going to be called for the foul as he roughs up Shadhari all the way down the floor.
And we see good find. I like the out-of-bounds play. Pop up top. Big man step in, find the ball, and just finish over with the right-hand floater.
Three minutes left, first half. Whistle starting to fly now. You notice that first game we called, not a lot of whistles. It was.
This is definitely a more physical game, more personal game too. So you see both teams playing a little different. They know each other better. But they're actually playing extremely hard, both teams, and it starts with Clovis North and that pressure that they're applying.
Well, that's a great point you just made. They know each other, you know. I've been playing against you since third grade.
It's a hometown rivalry.
I'm
right
coming
here.
After you. I know your move. I'm going to get there before you. See, that's a rough, rough shot, and Shadhari can't believe there was no call. He may have a point.
I like that they're letting them play, though. Clovis North as the initiators of the contact or the more aggressive team right now. You're not going to get every call in your favor.
Well, they are really getting after it with the pace here, and he
stepped out.
The Cardinal Sin had his foot on the sideline.
You see right here with the skip, and he just steps out that right foot, but they get another turnover, and he has no hesitation to shoot it again.
You like that green light?
Oh, he knows he got a green light.
The floater over the top of Muslay doesn't go.
Jackson
207 remaining in this first half. Hope you're enjoying all of this. This is the Heart of California Basketball Tournament on NorCalSportsTV.com. I'm Vance Palm and Lauren Goodman. She goes by Goody. You can call me VP if you want. We're just glad to be here. Seen a lot of familiar faces, a lot of great friends from my past, kids I've coached, coaches I've coached against.
And it's continuing to fill up with familiar faces. It's a big event for Northern California. Good opportunity to get some good basketball on display. Great way to start the basketball preseason.
Right. That's a great point.
Just off on that last one, but you see, trying to push the tempo. Good timing right there.
Nice looking bucket. And Lucas Jones finally found it. He's been looking for it, and that one looked nice. You know, the Broncos just look, and here's another turnover. Here they come, Goody. They just look so much more confident. A nice pass, beautiful dish right there, and a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout taken by Bullard. This is NorCalSportsTV.com.
You see Clovis North not taking off the pressure. To be so early in the season, they look like a pretty in-shape team being able to press the entire first half of this ball game.
It doesn't help that Bullard can't buy a bucket either. They're missing some easy layups. That only adds to the exasperation of head coach Tim Edmondson. Quick outlet. Here comes Jones. Cross-court pass. Good look. Wong. They come inside with it.
A lot of contact right there.
And Espinosa is one of those players that knows how to sell it, too. That was some contact, but sells it well. He'll go to the line. So it took, in the first game, Bickersville Christian took them almost the entire game to get into the eight-foul region. We're here already. In the second quarter, more physical game, more fouls being called. You made the point of the familiarity with these two teams. So, and then on top of that, Bullard's trying to do whatever they can to force turnovers, try to get caught up in this thing. They're down 23 in the first half. It was 1-1, and Espinosa missed. Turnover, Calvillo, Espinosa. Has the wherewithal to put it back in.
Nice spin. Should have probably went and tried to score something right there. Every time they pull it out, they give Clovis North the opportunity to reset their defense, get stronger.
In and out. Also having a tough night from the floor. These are not bad shots. They're just rattling in and out.
Well, that's also a factor to where we're playing tonight. I'm always adamant about getting a good warm-up in, being able to shoot when you're not in a familiar environment. And some of those little chippies that probably would fall in if we were playing at Clovis North right now probably would go in.
Great point. You know, they all worked out here last night. They got some time in the gym, but not nearly what you're speaking of, that, you know, that time to really, really get acclimated with this big arena and that depth perception. There's a look right there. Didn't go, but how about the follow? That won't count. Oh, I don't believe the shot will count, but it'll be a 1-1. Oh, they are going to count
the
bucket.
They're going to count it.
So the bucket will count. Here's a good look at it right here, Goody.
That was excellent pursuit right there. Nobody boxed him out, and typically that is the number one, I would say, gripe from a coach. Weak side rebounds. You got to find that person on the weak side, because typically long shot coming from the corner is going to bounce to that other side.
Got it. So Espinosa, amongst the hardest working players on the floor, he gets sent to the line. So a little bit of confusion here.
So they counted.
They counted the bucket, but did Espinosa shoot the bucket?
So they counted the bucket, but it was an off foul.
Now see,
a blocking foul for Espinosa, so he should have still got two shots.
Well, it's a one-and-one situation. They shot. It was a one-and-one foul, a bonus foul. Well, they're walking off the floor, so we'll take a wrap and try to figure it all out for you and deliver to the third quarter. 43-15, it is all Clovis North right now on the NorCalSportsTV.com coverage of the heart of California, Bakersfield.
Oh, that's a tough miss right there. It's always good to get off to a good start.
Here's your second one falling down. Third.
Ten seconds to play. They need another three to tie the game. Kubit, half court. Oh! Kubit knocks down the half court, ties the game. Oh my goodness.
You drove all the way up from Los Angeles.
From
we
Los
just
Angeles.
Heard that. What made you put Miles Little into the camp?
Well, you know, we were looking for an overnight camp that would really help develop his sort of independence. And this looked like a beautiful setting for the kids and also really foster his independence, meet new people. And I want to say one of the best things about this camp, this particular camp, is the ability to see the games live streamed on YouTube. It allows you to not be at camp but also still participate in that particular part of camp, and so I thought that was really amazing. The announcers were great, the angles, the instant replay, it really made the kids feel special.
Would you bring Miles Little back up to camp?
For sure, 100%, and we're bringing friends. I think one of the wonderful things that I saw when I came to pick him up is how collegial, supportive the older boys are with the younger boys, and I think that is really heartening for me, because that's how I want my boy to be when he grows up. And so I think that he has some really great examples of really kind people on and off the court here.
Thank you. one falling down.
Seconds to play. They need another three to tie the game. Kubin, half court. Oh! Kubin knocks down the half court, ties the game. Oh my goodness.
Oh, that's a tough miss right there. It's always good to get off to a good start.
Here's your second one falling down. Third.
Welcome back, everybody. Great to have you with us. This is the Heart of California Basketball Tournament on NorCalSportsTV.com. I'm just lucky to get her back. Somebody as big time as Goody is during halftime, everybody wants to talk to her. Everybody wants to come over and say hi. Who was your chat just with?
Just talking to Robert Fields, good time friend, family friend, head coach of Monterey Trail, talking about his team. Got a really talented senior in Varick Lewis who's going to Long Beach next year. He has a really good program, so he's been there for a 6 year. I'm actually one of the coaches that hired him at that position when I was the head coach at Monterey Trail, so that's family right there.
They're taking on Granada after this one. The one we're in now, Clovis North. Bullard, your thoughts on the first half?
Man, it's been all Clovis North. They've come out strong, really dominant, and Bullard, they got to respond. They got to play harder. I know Coach Atkinson, he wants his team to play tough, And they're not responding right now. It's a huge lead for Clovis North, but it comes from the results of their defense. They played outstanding on the defensive end, forcing turnovers. And I'm sorry, you can't win games, especially at a court like this, when you got 20-plus turnovers in the first half. It's not going to be successful.
And, Goody, the crowd's starting to fill in here, too, as we're getting closer to the two later games that we're going to be having. You just mentioned Monterey Trails here against Granada, and then the nightcap, Sierra Canyon, playing San Joaquin Memorial. As this crowd gets bigger and bigger here, you know, the head coach for Bullard, Coach Amundson, is telling them, hey, look, it's a big audience here, guys.
Mm-hmm. This is a good opportunity, too. Like, if anything, a lot of kids, it's a 1% chance or a 2% chance that a kid gets an opportunity to play at college level. And so just getting this experience in high school, the fans are coming in here, filling up a little bit more. This is a great timing for this championship game. Good placement for them to move it over here. It's just a great experience for the kids from Fresno and getting this experience.
43-15, that's the score. Only 15 for Bullard. They're going to have to do something different here in this third quarter. Let's go courtside. Here we go.
And they come out trying to push the tempo. A lot more ball movement. And there it is there, getting the bucket to start the third quarter, and that's exactly what they needed if you're a fan of Bullard right now.
Be aggressive right off the top. You know, I'm sure that he had to tell them that, look, we can't waste another minute. Well, that's a given, good, nice give and go, though. And into the corner it goes. And how about the work down low? First, he makes a great pass, and he comes in, gets the board, and puts it back up. That's Lucas Jones. Now almost gets a steal right there.
Now, we don't have an official stat book right now, but Clovis North on the offensive boards has been ridiculous. Somebody got to box somebody out in white.
Well, in the first 3 minutes, I think they had 10. Here's a fast break. That's got to be music to Coach Amundson's ears. That two-foot miss is not, though. That's not something he wants to see.
Shouldn't have picked his dribble up right there. Now he got him in trouble in a five count.
But he did not get rid of it. So Sean Wong gets himself in trouble.
We got a couple turnovers here early from the Broncos. I know Coach Tony Amundson is not excited about that. They definitely want to take care of the basketball and clean it up.
Tim at Bullard, Tony at Clovis North.
Good patience, good find right there. Two early buckets for Bullard.
What a nice, strong move. Did not finish. Gets his own board and puts it right back up again. Jalen Bryant to add to Goody's point. Another offensive rebound.
And that is probably number one high school coach's headache, as we see an easy floater coming down the middle, but boxing out and turning the basketball over. They probably say that more than a million times a day.
And that's just awfully, awfully easy right there. I mean, you've got Jalen Bryant just standing underneath the hoop, and they just hand it to him.
Bryant playing really well tonight.
There's a three, and it goes. Mark Williams drops it in, and I got to tell you, every time Bullard scores, it seems like there's a louder sound and more applause for the Knights than the Broncos. I don't know.
We always like an underdog story in basketball, I feel like. We want to see if you can claw your way out of it, make the game spicy, give us something to cheer about in this third quarter as we see the deep three right there, Williams in front of his bench. And I think it hits a little different when you hit a three in front of your bench.
True. It could have just been the players that made all that noise. If you're just getting with us on NorCalSportsTV.com, this second game that we're doing out of the four that we're doing, the Clovis North Bullard game you're watching, is actually the championship game from their local tournament. They moved the venue to the Save Mart. Brilliant move. Everybody loving it, except for the fact that Bullard's not playing their best basketball right now, but it's great to be out here on the Save Mart floor.
It is extremely great. One of my students, actually, Lavelle Bailey, is star standout for the football team here at Fresno State.
Love hearing that. Jump stop in the middle of the key, turns back out, throws it. Would have been a good inside-out move.
Clovis North is very fundamentally sound. Nice lob over the top.
Jaleel Jackson drops it in and gets fouled.
And if you're the Knights, you got to be at least proud of how Jahlil Jackson has been playing tonight. He just really works hard, runs the floor hard, hasn't pouted any moment, and that's one of my number one things. A lot of players in basketball, they love to pout. They love to get upset every mistake that they make. But those ones that can kind of fight through adversity, that shows a lot about their character.
I noticed that's the second pout reference. I've got you already. I mean, I noticed that. No, and I totally agree. I mean, it's just, you know, your body language, your body English, even from 50 rows back, it can send a message. Strong move. Challenge down low, big contact as Malik Muzle goes in and gets the rebound. And as we can see, Coach Tim Adminson telling his Bullard Knights, just go up straight with him. I know he's taller, but just go up straight. You reach like that right there from Keyshawn Johnson, and that's going to be a foul. 99 times out of 100 when you move forward with your arms, it's almost a gift to an official.
Any swipe, they just know to call on those type of plays.
Back in is David Rios and Javance Coleman.
It seems like at some point Muzle got hit in the eye as he airballs that one.
That's what he'll say right then.
It was a Band-Aid. It was the Band-Aid under my eye.
I got hit in the face. What do you expect, Goody?
Nice soft touch on the first one, not so quiet on the second one.
The Broncos still bringing it. They're up big and still with the full court pressure. And how about the transition D by Shadhari? Now he brings it down himself and gives it up to the big guy. Boy, that's a highlight reel for Nazir Shadhari. Contact and it goes. The foul will be on Malik. But David Rios challenges the big fella, uses his body as a shield. Here's a nice look at it right here.
Rios going up. It's a little hesitation. I like with a lot of guards, it's kind of the Ja Morant thing, Kyrie Irving thing, where you can pause in the air, change direction in the air. That's where you get a little timing to open up to get that hack shack across the chase.
52-29. Putting the effort in, battling back all they can do. How about the quick-handed McKay Adminson? Talked about that. In the first half, there's a nice look right there. It comes up short. The offensive rebound, but then the turnover.
Look up.
Jake Prunetta. Oh, nice move.
Got to finish.
He saw Malik standing there and kicks it into the corner. There's the turnover, and it's going to be Max Landon. Does Landon get up? He lays it up. Easy 2 points. So Max Landon, the senior.
Landon for two.
And that's exactly why. You got to go look at the basket. Do not miss your opportunities because sometimes you'll force it unnecessarily.
Absolutely. Baseline move, kicks it back out. There's a shot taken by Rios, and it goes.
Rios waking up, quick six right here in the third.
The pesky defense by these Bullard Knights. They're staying on it. The whistle blows. Who will it be on? Yeah, it's going to be on a Bronco, I think. Oh, no, they're going back with it.
Good hustle there by Rios. And, again, I try to tell players that offense creates your defense sometimes, okay? So he saw the bucket go in, got the and-one play, comes back, hits the three. Now you're going. Now he's diving on the ground, getting tip deflections. It's all plays into the package of how you want to play and keeping it consistent.
Down 22, but not looking like it. Playing strong, playing hard.
Travel.
That's a travel. He picked up his pivot foot. So you got two coaches here that we see it all, don't we? Vindiola picked up his pivot foot.
Those are one of those plays where you are on the sideline. If officials have missed that one, coaches go crazy.
And I'll tell you what, Nathaniel Vindiola is a freshman, though, a tall, lanky freshman. And it goes. And Coach Tim Amundson couldn't believe it. He thought that, if we take a look right here as well, he thought for sure, well, that's a play just before that, but he thought his big fella just went straight up and did not make contact with Jalen Bryant. He didn't like the call because he can feel, even though they're down 20, Goody, he can feel, you know, the fight and the effort in his Bullard Knights. They have not cashed it in.
Momentum has been all Bullard Knights in this third.
They're still pushing it down the floor. Rios, nice pass over to the wing. That's wide open. Can't get it to go. Offensive rebound. No, it's going to end up in the hands of the Broncos.
And you can tell that energy, that pickup of pace has happened for Bullard. As Bryant loses it right there.
Yeah, exactly. I think the ball slipped out of his hands. He had a great move, just went way up on the glass. Nice jump stop and a big swing forward. That swipe not called. That was an aggressive block. Contact and it goes in Jordan Espinoza. I'll tell you what, the junior guard has really played a role. Here's a look at it right now. Goes up. Strong
nice
body, right? And this is the young man that had four offensive rebounds in the first 10 seconds of the game. He missed three one-footers.
He's for surely the motor for Clovis North. He works really hard playing inside out, but it's his movement. His movement without the basketball, that's what I'm impressed about.
Another long bomb. Rios able to snag it and says, oh, that was unfortunate. The ball slipped out of his hands as he pulled the trigger. He went to make the shot, slipped out of his hands, so he tried to be creative. He slips out, and he tries to go back and get it, but he left his feet, jumped, hopped, went back to get it, and the officials even grinning with him. They had a rare moment of levity between official and player.
That's one of those moments where you got to put some spit on your shoes, grab your hands, grab your shorts, get locked in, because that could have been a potential bucket, but it's a turnover.
Long attempt, looked good. Jackson, again, boy, he looks nice coming down the floor, doesn't he?
And he always keeps his head up, which is really important as a point guard.
And the putback, nobody blocked him out.
Putback at number 10, Jaleel Jackson.
And Jaleel Jackson, even more special, showing you to his athleticism. He pushes the tempo and point, gets an offensive rebound, and then he picks the ball up full court. Good find.
Here comes Bullard.
Mignola to the hole for two.
Down 19, but it doesn't feel like it.
It's been all Bullard in this third quarter.
I tell you what, Espinoza just knows how to find contact. You know players like that, Coach. They just know how to find contact and bring it to them. They're magnetic.
And that was good patience by Bullard to play before Espinoza got to the line. But, again, finding his way to get to the line, get to be involved. I know Coach Tony Amison, You gotta love a player like that, Coach. You gotta be able to say, hey man, he can do anything, do the intangibles, do the dirty work. And again, he doesn't need the basketball in his hands every play to be successful.
There's a good look at Espinoza. Converts back to a 21-point lead.
And you see Clovis North back in that press and get the turnovers that they want.
And they almost they're bringing the break to them. They're not really worried about the press offense. They want it to come to them. And now all of a sudden, Jordan Espinoza has said, hey, Vance, I've heard enough of this talk that Bullard's coming back. Stop. Oh, nice move by Major Hurley. 64 seconds remain in the third quarter. Nice crowd starting to file in here at the Save Mart Center.
And again, Espinoza, he's our utility guy of the night right now. He can pretty much do a little bit of everything. Pull it out, shoot, run the tempo, slash without the basketball, rebound. He's doing it all for Clovis.
He's going to get a break right now. Wow. The full revolving door for Clovis North. Five in, five out. As we're going to see Elias Gish back in. Nazir Shadar, we've seen him already a couple times. McKay Adminson.
And again, their dribble weave, dribble handoff, dribble kick. Good defense right there, Rios.
It sure is.
Applying pressure. You got to be able to read on those handoffs and on those ball screens when you want to go double it. And it's always up to the player's discretion. Go have some freedom. When you know you're close enough, go get that trap. And you see the results there.
from behind. They hassle him enough. What a bucket. Strong move by Keyshawn Johnson. Wow. Some more pressure out top by Blue. Here they come. Oh, stripped again. A little frenetic pace here in the last 30 seconds of this third quarter.
Tim Edmondson almost lost it right there when they lost that basketball. Just too many turnovers is really what's killing the Knights.
And you remember the first quarter they couldn't buy a bucket. Missed a bunch from point-blank range. Last 10 seconds of this third quarter.
Let's see this execution by Clovis North.
Amundsen goes up, really uncontested. And at the buzzer, a couple of another close shots that just didn't go in. 62-40, 22-point lead, one quarter left here on NorCalSportsTV.com.
One falling down.
How about this? The All Camps broadcast by NorCal Sports TV. One of the highlights of the summer camp. The NorCal Sports TV summer camp. And it's all broadcasted. How about that? Meals and lodging included. This is up in the mountains in NorCal. What an unbelievable experience for these boys and girls to go up there and, first of all, experience outdoor and take the phones. And
it is an extremely great week, especially that we get to broadcast it, but also just all the kids getting an opportunity to just go on a camp. And who can fight a basketball camp? Come on now.
Up in the hills. And here come the Bullard Knights. Fourth quarter action. You can see the score. They're down 22, now 19.
And that would be our guy, Javance Coleman.
Oh, I love that guy. Never met him in my life, but I'm going to find his parents and say thank you. Coleman, a freshman guard, misses the free throw. So still, the deficit is 19, but there's no getting around the fact that this second half, the pressure, the effort, that's a foul up top by Allen, but the energy has been on the side of Bullard High School. But the big lead going into halftime by Clovis North may be insurmountable. We'll see. Emerson pulls the trigger, has it blocked from behind, comes up and gets fouled down low. Will it be a shooting foul? He got his own rebound and tried to spin one up off the glass. And he will go to the line. Look at the effort here by the diminutive point guard. I don't think Tim Amundsen can believe it. He's like, look, that's my nephew. I know how sneaky he can be. We didn't touch him.
That's got to be a great basketball house. And just a freshman.
He looks like it, doesn't he?
Definitely.
I mean, we saw some freshmen in the first game. Barre is a 6'9 freshman or something like along those lines. But young McKay Amundsen, to his credit, I say it in the most jealous of ways. Oh, a turnover and the aforementioned McKay Amundsen. He's going to go up against the big dogs, and this time the big dog wins. Javance Coleman bats it away.
Just a little Wilson burger on this evening. We see here. little fella. I try to tell my little guards, I don't know who you think you are. Just go ahead and give us a different move or change of direction because it's going to probably get swatted up out of this racket.
Do you ever tell them from, like, past experience?
Of course.
You're transparent enough to say,
listen,
look.
I never forget my freshman year in college. We played Ole Miss at Ole Miss. Got my shot blocked to the third row of the stands. And Coach immediately took me out the game.
And Coach probably didn't say anything like, now, Goody, I know you're going to use that later on in your coaching life, but I don't care.
Nah, you're getting out the game. What are we doing here right now?
Great backdoor. Maybe try to do too much with it. Birchall could have just gone in directly with it. Went under the hole.
And Mousselet right there. Got to keep the ball a little higher. Good physicality down there. Just patience from Coleman.
Love the effort. Here is Malik Mousselet. Gets it to go. Again, we talked about this at the beginning of the game. 6'8". He looks like he's leaning towards the 6'9 realm. But this senior has nice touch as well. Really nice defender. Clovis North rattles that one out.
And like immediately, they set up from the free throw to set up in that press to pick up full court. As you saw Wong picking up full court, Espinoza picking up full court.
Mark Williams going hard of the hole, number 12. We'll see number 12 for the Broncos come in. Jalen Bryant. Rios back in. Dakota Richardson, haven't seen a ton of him, but he's back in. Great defense there by the Broncos.
Bullard trying to get Coleman the ball. It just wasn't successful there.
They're packing the D down low. Great rotation by Rios to disrupt what might have been an easy layup.
Another weak side rebound for Clovis North. And who's down there? Espinoza again for two.
You said it. He does so much without the ball.
Oh, he's moving without the basketball. If you don't know where he's at, you're in trouble.
Because once he gets it, it's virtual points. High up off the glass by Coleman.
Coleman being all the offense here for Bullard in this fourth.
Battle for it down low. Ends up in Rios' hands.
That's a battle I definitely don't want to be in. Espinoza making a strong spin move, and then he tries to go get his own rebound. Jesus.
We're going to dip below the five-minute mark here in just a few seconds. Strong power move to the hole. And Jaleel Jackson.
And again, it's the extended pressure. It's putting them out of position a little bit. And they don't get stops when they press, as you see there. Another easy layup.
Yeah, Bryant just throws one off the glass. But there's some gaps in that defense for Bullard that will need to be tightened up. Goodness. Some serious contact, but no call. Jaleel Jackson got roughed up, and Coach Admonson may have a good point, saying, look, my guy couldn't even get the ball up off his chest. Struggle for it. And the pressure is there, and Abinson is not happy with his team or with the officials, and he's let the officials know, first of all. Looks like it's a 30. We'll be right back.
We're back. 4:21 to go in this one. Broncos leading 73-49 over the Knights. Some hometown cooking. Nice press break. Look to the basket.
Who hustles back for the block?
Espinoza with a Wilson off the glass, that one. But again, I think it's a little bit overpassing. You got to be a little bit more selfish if you're the Bullard Knights, because I think they're pushing too deep, trying to kind of find the gaps in the seams and making that low-end pass. But in reality, they need to look towards the rim a little bit more.
73-49. 4:12 remaining here in the fourth. There's Jalen Bryant.
Jalen Bryant unsuccessful on that one. Just short. And here come Bullard in full steam, trying to get something to create, some type of shot. The patience in Coleman there, unsuccessful.
Look out. Oh.
And Rios. And that back line putting in a little extra work. That was a good read. Got a tip off a Bronco player, and now it's going back Bullard's way.
You know, Coach, early in the season you have a game like this where, again, we saw it in the first game between BCHS and St. Joe's. When you're down big this early in the season, you just got to keep working. Got to keep grinding. You got to keep going to class. You got to keep learning. There's a nice back door right there. Really nice. And that's a big swat by Bryant. Makes a little bit of contact. Now he's going to run the break. Bryant kicks it off down low. But how about that right there? Jake Prunetta. Oh, they get it back and lay it in.
Wong's been really a special kid. Just coming in, playing defense, taking charges, getting a couple 6 points in there. When you can get 6 to 8 points from a player like Wong, who's not an instrumental piece of your offense, just a role player, that's really good for a team.
Absolutely. It's like your golf team with 6 golfers in your high school or college team, and your 5th player comes in and shoots 79. Mm-hmm. Like, wow, we'll take that.
We'll take it.
Right, thank you.
Hence what's leading to their almost 30-point lead here.
Well, I see some bright spots with Bullard, though, as well. I sure see some talented young players out there that they can keep the attitude going. Look at the strong move. He's fouled all the way across the key by Gish, so it's a nice move.
And they're good. I think they'll move to 3-1 this season. They've started strong. They've had some good competition. As well as this is a good test game of seeing what not to do. Just imagine if they don't dig that 20-point hole, almost 30-point hole in the first half, have a different ball game here.
Well, like we talked about, the energy certainly seems to be with those blue jerseys for most of this second half. 3 minutes left in our second of 4 big-time Central California games. We're going to go NorCal for the next game. Monterey Trail and Granada. Oh, look at a dish right
Ooh.
There. Hey, Mark
Make
Williams.
Make a stop, Williams. He said, hold on now. The game's not over.
Allen will come in for Rios. Rios put a lot of great minutes.
Good timing, good hustle right there.
Boy, how do you like that look down at the big guy right away? Floated out. It's going to be Amundson.
Nobody's aware of the shot clock. There it is. Good defense by Bullard.
Our first shot clock violation of the evening.
Now, I think it's something really key right here for Clovis North. They're playing with like a couple of their second string guys and some of their third string guys. So getting quality minutes here, playing over 4 minutes in this fourth quarter, just getting the opportunity to play on this court again. It shows to their depth and as well as their how good they're going to be going on the rest of the season.
A beautiful give and go. Fantastic. Christopher Stanley off the give from Malik Hawari. That was some textbook basketball. Amundson pulls the trigger, doesn't get it to go. Rebound by Gish. .146 remains in our second night Second game of the night, BCHS and St. Joe's. First game of the evening, St. Joe's handled that one. Coming up next, Monterey Trail and Granada. And then our final game of the evening, Sierra Canyon and San Joaquin.
Should be very eventful. Hopefully our viewership will go up online. I know a lot of Sacramento people will be watching, unable to travel today due to the rain. And I like both coaches just giving everybody an opportunity to get on the court and play, get some shots. And I know it's going to be some great photos out there to get to see themselves as we see a bucket right there from Stanley. He's kind of waking up.
Yeah, he's come alive here towards the end.
But he's got really good size. I thought we would see more of him throughout the game. Just wasn't able to keep it going. But he's a good size young player.
And as a senior, you'd think as a senior, maybe there's maybe more to it.
There's always a work in progress, and I'm going to tell you, it's a lot of junior colleges watching right now, a lot of lower-level D2, D3 schools that's looking for diamonds in the rough like that.
That's a great point. How many times have I said that tonight, great point?
I'm trying to be on my game as much as possible.
Here we go. If I say great point 50 times tonight.
It's true to the chemistry that we got. I think it was instantaneously. We matched each other's swag tonight.
You talk about instantaneously. This young lady was stuck behind a traffic accident in the Northern California freeways. When I say she rolled in and we went on the air, it is no exaggeration. And thank goodness we've known each other for 15 years or it wouldn't have been pulled off that way. How about this? Here comes Bullard. Still working, still going hard. JP Pernetta still making it work.
And I like it. Let's play. All we want is not to be a 20-point blowout, okay? I can be respectable. I think both teams are going to remember this. And, you know, we talked about that continuity and playing against each other since the third grade. We're going to remember, hey, I smacked you guys by 20.
At save mark.
At save mark. So it's going to be some instrumental moments and memories here. So everybody's just playing hard. So it's not that 20-point blowout that they're going to have to face probably in 20 years when they're at reunions and talking to each other and having this great fond memory.
Hats off to Tony Amundsen and his crew, Drew Crisp, Daniel Dyke, John Jones, Benton Lewis, and Calvin Young III. Get a win over his brother, Tim Amundsen, and his staff, Ian Hayashi, Travis Johnson, Nicholas Tom, Mike Villaniti, and Kyle Yano Ghosts as we come into the end of this one. And I think that's going to wrap it up. 75-54 ended up being a 21-point lead for the Broncos of Clovis North over Bullard High School. We'll take a break when we come back next. Northern Cal, Monterey Trail, and Granada. For Goody, I'm Vance. We'll be back in a little bit here. The heart of California basketball on NorCalSportsTV.com.